I know that I
You're an angel waiting for me. By his parents in the temple. In turn, he took young children in his arms and blessed them, celebrating the gift of life and the faithfulness of God. We covenant together as parents and as a church, making promises before God for the sake of this child. Here we share joy of the gift of Emily Rose and praise God, the giver of life. We celebrate family life. Acknowledging that children are not the property of parents, but named before God. They are persons with whose welfare and nurture we are entrusted. Concerned about the dangerous world into which they were born, and honestly aware of the sinfulness which has soon marred our lives, we here pray in trust that God will bless and protect them. Together we celebrate the importance of community and the truth that parents and children need not be alone. Here we confess and proclaim that all our hope rests in Jesus Christ and the best we want for our children is that they become true disciples. Scriptures call us to see in children the sign of the kingdom of God. Emily Rose is a living sign that God welcomes us without condition, lavishing love and grace on all who come to him with empty hands and open hearts. And here's some biblical readings to confirm all the above. Firstly, from Deuteronomy chapter 6, verses 4 through 7. Hear, O Israel, the Lord is our God, the Lord alone. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your might. Keep these words that I am commanding you today in your heart. Recite them to your children and talk about them when you are at home and when you are away, when you lie down and when you rise. Bind them as a sign of your hand, fix them as an emblem on your forehead, and write them on the doorpost of your house and on your gates. In the New Testament, Matthew 18, 1 through 5. At that time, the disciples came to Jesus and asked, who is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven? He called the child, and he put among them and said, truly I tell you, unless you change and become like children, you will never enter the kingdom of heaven. Whoever becomes humble like this child is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven. Whoever welcomes one such child in my name welcomes me. And finally, from Mark's Gospel, chapter 10, verse 13 through 16, people were bringing little children to him in order that he might touch them. The disciples spoke sternly to them. And when Jesus saw this, he was indignant and said to them, "Let the little children come to me. Do not stop them, for it is to such as these that the kingdom of God belongs. Truly I tell you, whoever has not received the kingdom of God as a little child will never enter it." And he took them up in his arms, laid his hands on them, and blessed them. Let's pray this prayer of thanksgiving. A prayer of praise and thanksgiving for God, the creator of all life, and for the gift of Emily Rose in particular. Lord God, creator of all things, giver of life, we praise you. You are the loving parent of each person, and joyfully we thank you now for the gift of new life and the birth of this child, Emily Rose. For all that you have given and will give to us through her, and for the possibilities of her new life, we thank you. For the love which has beckoned her into existence, for the love and hope she has awakened, and for the care which surrounds her, we give you our thanks and praise. In the name of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. So we come to the parents' promises. Tim and Tracy, do you thank God for the gift of this child, Emily Rose, and do you accept the joys and duties of parenthood?
We do.
Not Tim, it's gladly we do. Do you promise to bring your daughter up within the Christian community and by God's grace so to live that she was nurtured by Christian love and surrounded by the life of Jesus?
As disciples of Jesus, we do.
What names have you given to your daughter? You have your own, okay. I'm going to swap you, you're going to hold this for me and I'm going to hold your...
Good luck.
There we go, you're actually shooting. Right, here we go, Emily Rose. Emily Rose Fletcher, we greet you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ and welcome you into the community of God's people. Okay, gathered here as members of this congregation and friends and family of Tim and Tracy and representatives of the wider Church of God, do you promise to offer Emily Rose and her family your love and support and be faithful in prayer? Will you share your faith with her by word and by example? If you promise to do this, please stand. Emily, we rejoice for you. Our God's gift to us. Glad I've given you back, God. You are God's gift to us. Grow strong in the knowledge and the love of God. We pray that one day you will become a disciple of Jesus Christ, following him through the waters of baptism and in the life of a faithful witness. Bear the fruit of his Spirit. Live by his great gift of love. Emily, the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift the light of his countenance upon you and give you peace this day and always. Amen. Jesus never had this problem. Let's pray. Loving God, we thank you for the gift of Emily Rose, and now we pray for her protection and flourishing. Father, we live in a difficult and dangerous world, and we ask, Lord, to keep her safe from harm. We pray for Tim and Tracy and ask for your help in the care and nurture of Emily. We pray she might know your love through their love. Discover your guidance through their guidance and come to trust in you and become a disciple of Jesus Christ. This we ask in the name of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. Welcome, Emily Rowe. And then Tim and Tracy are going to praise this lovely baby. Oh, you were such a good girl. Wonderful, isn't it? Thank you.